our channel, become our patron. Visit patreon.com/cyclemaintenanceacademy.
Hi, and welcome to Cycle Maintenance Academy. In today's video, I would like to show you how do the quick release mechanisms work and how to replace the quick release skewer correctly. But before we begin, as always, don't forget to subscribe to this channel and like the video. Okay, are you ready? Then let's begin.
Some wheels have quick release levers rather than nuts to hold them in place. Quick release skewers are 5mm in diameter and fit a 9mm axle. Anything bigger is classified as a thru axle skewer. Quick release skewers come in three lengths. The shorter skewer is for the 100mm axle in the front wheel. The longer skewer actually comes in two very similar lengths. Road bike rear wheels use a skewer designed for a 130mm axle. And mountain bike, hybrid bike rear wheels use a skewer that is made for 135mm axles. Although the mountain bike hybrid skewer is also compatible with road bike rear wheels, the road bike skewer might not be long enough to clamp a mountain bike or hybrid wheel. Quick release mechanisms. Quick release skewers work by opening and closing the lever using an eccentric cam system. Yours will either have an enclosed mechanism or an exposed mechanism. With the enclosed mechanism, the lever is attached eccentrically to the skewer shaft inside the lever body. As the lever is being turned to the closed position, it pulls the skewer shaft against the lever body, which compresses against the dropout, locking the wheel into position. With the exposed mechanism, the round end of the lever is attached eccentrically to the end of the skewer shaft. When moving the lever into the locked position, the round bit of the lever rotates off-center, applying pressure to the toothed washer below, clamping the wheel to the dropouts. Undoing the quick release skewer. To remove the quick release skewer, first look at the lever. Some levers have open marked on one side and closed on the other. Now, looking at the quick release skewer fitted onto the bike, if you can't see closed on the lever, then the wheel is secured. If you can't find writing on your skewer, then have a look at the lever. You will see that it curls in when it is closed. To release the wheel, pull the lever towards you. This will open the quick release mechanism. Hold the lever in one hand and slightly unscrew the nut, just enough to be able to remove the wheel. Don't take your skewer right out of the axle. It isn't necessary for wheel removal and you might lose the bits. If you're not sure how to remove the front wheel, our video here will guide you through this task. Watch our video here if you need help with removing the rear wheel. Tightening a quick release skewer. Put the bike upside down. First, locate the spring onto the skewer so that the wider end of the spring settles into the lever. At the rear, push the skewer through the axle from the non-drive side. If you have a bike with disc brakes, then at the front, push the skewer through the axle from the drive side. If you don't have disc brakes, then it doesn't really matter. The protruding part will have a thread showing. Put the remaining spring onto the skewer with the thinner end against the axle. Now screw on the nut 4 or 5 turns. To secure the wheel, first choose the position where the lever will be locked. Now put the lever 180 degrees to the final position and hold it in place. Start to tighten the nut clockwise. When you can start to feel it tighten, stop and push the lever into its final position. It should start biting at 90 degrees. If it doesn't, move the lever back to the starting point and tighten a bit more. If it starts biting earlier, then move the lever back to the starting point and loosen the skewer nut a bit. Now use the heel of the hand for the final closure. You should feel a small resistance when closing the lever. If you struggle to push the lever to its final position, then don't force it, as you will make it too tight and it will be very difficult to open again. You will lose the advantage of a quick release. If you don't feel the resistance when tightening it, then the wheel might not be secured enough and the skewer could flop open, causing the wheel to come off. Be aware that the quick release skewer doesn't tighten the wheel in the same way as wheel nuts, so don't use the lever to tighten the skewer like a wing nut. There are ridges on each end of the skewer that grip on the dropout. If the lever is tightened rather than locked, then the serrations on the lever will have spun instead of biting into place, resulting in the wheel not being fitted in place as tightly as it should be.
Thanks for watching all the way to the end, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to let us know in the comments below how you got on replacing the quick release skewer.